Welcome to Excel Campus. My name is John, and in this video, I'm going to explain how to use VBA macros to copy and paste data to another workbook. So we're first going to look at a very simple example of copying this static range to another workbook. But of course, that's not always what we need in the real world. So we're also going to look at examples of copying data where the number of rows in our source range changes, and also where the destination range already has existing data. We might want to paste below that, or we might want to first delete this existing data and then paste to this range. So we'll first start with the basics of doing a simple copy and paste between workbooks. I'll make the VB editor full size here so we can dive into this code. And I will also make this workbook available for free download, and I'll put a link in the description below this video so you can follow along. So copying data between workbooks is actually very simple and only requires one line of code. And we're going to do that using the Range.Copy method. And that's this line here. Now you see it's actually two lines, but I've really just continued on this one single line with the underscore character. So really we're using this Range.Copy method, and I'll just add a space here and we can type it out. Type range.copy. If we tab into that and hit space, we'll see that the copy method here has one parameter, which is the destination. So this is the destination range of where we want to paste to. And that's exactly what this line of code is doing up here. So we have the source range. We're also referencing the workbook and the worksheet where with this range exists. So this exists in this new data workbook. The workbook name is newdata.xlsx. And then this sheet that exists in is the export sheet. And then we have this range A2 to D9 that we're going to copy. And then the destination for that copy, or where we're going to paste to, is this range right here, just starting in cell A2 on the data sheet in the reports.xlsm workbook. So let's go ahead and test this out. I'm first going to delete this line of code here. Control Y is the keyboard shortcut to do that. Then I'll move the VB editor back over here. I have all of these files kind of lined up so we can actually see the code run. And we'll go ahead and just place the text cursor in here. You can hit F8 on the keyboard to step through this, or F5 to run it. So again, this is just one single line of code here. You can see it, the code highlighter highlights both lines. Hit F8 on the keyboard, and then we can see over here that this range has been pasted right here in our destination workbook, which is reports.xlsm. We'll go ahead and hit F8 again to stop running the macro. And then there are a few important points to remember here that I want to point out. So I've listed these right here, but it's important to understand that first of all, both of the workbooks must be open on the computer. And we can use code to open and close the workbooks. So we can use code to first open the workbook, then run this copy line on it, and then even close the workbook again if we don't need it open. I've included in this workbook this open close methods module that shows and has some macros for both the workbooks.open method and the workbooks.close method. So I put links to the help pages for those as well, and you can check that out. But if you do want to first open the workbook, maybe you're exporting data, you want to open that workbook, then copy and paste and then close it, you can absolutely do all of that with macros. And then we'll jump back here. Another important point is that we must reference the correct file extension in the workbook's property. So you'll notice here that I'm referencing the file extension as well of each of these files. .xlsx is our new data file. The reports file is a macro-enabled workbook, .xlsm. But it's just important to remember to reference these file extensions along with the correct file name for the workbook's property. And another important point is that these workbooks do not have to be macro enabled. I listed that right here. They could both be .xlsx files. So you could copy and paste between files that are not macro enabled. So you could store the code somewhere else. You could store it in your personal macro workbook if you're doing this task frequently. I have a whole nother video series that explains the personal macro workbook in more detail, and I'll put a link to that in the description below this video. But basically there, you could store a macro in that workbook and run it anytime because that workbook opens every time you open Excel. And then another important point is that we do not need to select or activate the workbooks or the worksheets or even the ranges that we're copying and pasting to. So if you've used the macro recorder before and got code from the macro recorder to do this task, You might have a lot more code than this because the macro recorder is going to record your steps to activate or select the other workbook, select the worksheet that you want to paste to and copy from and all that. You're going to have additional lines of code for that. But as long as we create the correct references and context to the workbook, worksheet, and range that we want to copy from and also paste to, we can do this in all in one line of code without having to select those other objects. If you're enjoying this video, please click that big red subscribe button below the video to subscribe to our channel, and also click the notification bell icon there to get notified when new videos are published. Now, there are other ways to copy data, and I've included a few additional macros in this module here. This one down here uses the paste special method. So this is using two lines of code. The first line of code is going to use the copy method and just copy that range to the clipboard. And then we're going to use a separate line of code with the paste special method. And this allows us to choose the paste type. I currently have it set to paste values, but we could also paste formulas or formats or any of the paste special options. And I have a whole other video series that explains these copy and paste methods in more details. I'll put a link to that in the description below this video as well. And then finally, we could also use the method to set values. And I have a macro for that here as well. And in this case here, we're just setting the value of this range to the value of another range, which would be our copy range. So this is an alternate technique for copy and paste values. But again, the main point here is that we can do this operation very easily with one or two lines of code, as long as we reference the workbook and the worksheet and the range properly. Okay, so now let's take a look at a bit more of a real world or advanced example where the size of the ranges might be changing. So you might be doing this task every week or even every day, and the size of the data ranges changes for both the copy range and maybe you want to paste below the existing data on the destination range. So I've included a macro in this workbook as well, and it's here in this paste below module, and it's called copy paste below last cell. Now I have a few other videos that explain how to find the last used cell on a worksheet, and also how to do this entire process of copy and paste below an existing range. And I'll put links to those in the description below this video. So I won't go into this in too much detail, but we will walk through this macro and see how it works. So the first thing we have up here is just a few variables that we've set for those worksheets, for our copy range and worksheet and workbook within the copy range, or where we're going to copy the data from, and then the destination workbook as well. And then we're going to use the range.end method here to find the last used row in column A of both of these sheets. So this one here will set the variable for the last used row in the copy range. And then the same code is used down here for the destination range as well. And then we just have a line of code that does the copy and paste. So let's take a look at this. We'll step through it and see how it works. I'm going to move the VBA editor over here a bit. Go ahead and hit F8 on the keyboard to start stepping through this. We can see those two variables have been set. We'll run that line of code. Again, that's going to find the last used row on the copy sheet. We can see that's returning a 10. This line here, I'll hit F8 to step through that one, will show us the last used row on the destination sheet. And actually, we've offset that by one. I'll move this over here so you can see at the end, we've offset that by one. So we've added an additional row there. And so that's really setting our destination row, or last row here, to the first blank row. And then this last row down here is again using the range.copy method, that single line there. And here we're just using our variables within the range references. So we've joined or concatenated this variable here that's returning a 10 to this range reference. So this is actually going to return A2 to D10. And then we're going to paste that starting in column A and row 12. So this would be return A12. So we're just going to do that copy and paste there. I'll hit F8 on the keyboard to run that line. And we can see our new data has been pasted right down here. And again, this is fully dynamic. So when we come back and run this next time, maybe we have less rows here in our copy range. I'll just delete some rows just so we can see how this works. And we'll still have this same number of rows in our destination range. I can just jump in here, run the macro, and that again is going to paste all of those new rows down here to the bottom of our destination range. And then I've included another macro here below this one, which will clear the existing data before doing the paste. So the setup is really the same here. Let me move this over so you can see it. Really the same code. The only change is we're going to clear the contents of that range after we find the last used row in our destination range. We're going to use the clear contents method to clear out those cells, and then we do the copy and paste. So again, we could just move this over here. We'll just run this real quick to see how it works. That again will delete everything that was existing in that range there. Oops, there we go. And then we'll see we just have a straight copy and paste of the new data into this range. And then one final thing I wanted to mention is that we can use alternative references for the workbook's property. So in this case here, I've used the this workbook property instead, and this workbook will reference the workbook that the code is in. So the code is currently in the reports workbook. So instead of this line of code here or this section, I've replaced it with this workbook. And the advantage to using the this workbook property is that if the file name changes, if we were to change the name of the reports workbook to something else, we won't have to go change our code. It'll just always reference this workbook because this is the workbook, again, that this code module is stored in. You don't have to do this. As I mentioned before, you can copy and paste from workbooks and the code can be stored in a completely separate workbook or your personal macro workbook or an add-in or something like that. But I just wanted to point out that you can use this reference as well to, again, make your code a little more dynamic and require less maintenance. And then one other issue you might face is that you don't know the name of the worksheet from the data you're copying from. So if you're exporting data from a system, you might not always know the worksheet name. If we jump back over to Excel here, this tab name might change, or the sheet name might change every time you export new data. And we can also account for that in VBA. So if we jump back over to the VB editor here, in this line of code where we set reference to this worksheet and created a variable for it, instead of referencing the worksheet by its name, we can instead reference it by its index number or the position that it's in within the workbook. So that would be the first sheet in the workbook. We just reference it with the number one there, no quotation marks. And again, that's going to then just reference this first worksheet here in the workbook, regardless of what the name of it is. And of course, if the exported workbook has multiple worksheets and it's always the second sheet that you're copying from or something like that, then you can change this reference to a 2 or whatever the position is of the sheet within the workbook. So I hope that helps you save time with copying and pasting data between workbooks. If some of those techniques are new to you, I put quite a few links in the description below this video with additional resources and training. If you're new to VBA, I highly recommend taking the time to write out this code and practice. That will really help you learn VBA and also go beyond the macro recorder. So if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. If you'd like to learn more about macros, then join me for a free upcoming webinar on the 7 steps to getting started with macros in VBA. During this training, I'm going to explain how to write your first macro, what order the code runs in, what the dots between the words mean, and some of these complex things that are hard to understand when we're starting out with macros. So this will really help you automate Excel and save a ton of time with your job. So click the link right below this video to get registered for the free webinar, and I look forward to seeing you there.